Okay, my name is Ray Merrill. I'm the CEO, founder of DeMeros Academy Fathletes Fitness Center. So we have the A for A. Everybody thinks it's triple A, but it's A for A for the Academy for Athletes. I'm here, I train like adults, kids in the community, surrounding communities, athleticism, or just helping people get fit.
Now your guys, they did an excellent job today. They talked about the facility. One of them talked about how it's friendly, family friendly. I want you to just talk about that, like mother, father, brother, sister, you know, talk about that, the family friendliness.
Well, as soon as you walk in here, man, we have the welcome mat for you all to come in here. Whether you the race is black, Puerto Rican, whatever it is, we all just open arms to everybody. We have no type of discrimination towards anyone. We make everybody feel welcome, like in love and everything. We're very supportive of one another. If they see somebody on the machine that's not doing it right, whoever it is, they just go over there and help them out. And that's what we're all about. We're just here to help each other get fit in life.
No. Now, I was fortunate enough to come in here when it was just a vision. And, you know, I remember having that conversation with you. We took some still pics and we did a little promo video. And I was like, bro, look at my hands. You see how clean my hands are? How soft my hands is?
Right.
And what I do, I can't, you know, do the construction, tearing down walls and stuff like that. But I can do what I can do with the vision that God gave me as far as a videographer and a photographer. Mm-hmm. But now we're gonna take a little tour and we're gonna show them how magnificent this place is. Cause when I came in here, my mouth dropped like, wow. You know, I came in here earlier with my daughter and I was like, just so I could know where I was gonna be shooting at. Mm-hmm. But when I seen the facilities and the vision that you told me, it came out exactly like you said it was gonna come out. So tell us a little bit about, for the people that's going to experience how nice it is, tell us about how it was when it was just a vision.
Well, if you can remember, I was two doors down at first. And I guess the facility, it didn't fit my need like everything I was going to be doing in here. So God blessed me actually with a bigger building, which is two doors right here. And I sat in here one time, you know, we had to get all the stuff, it was a bank. We had to get all the bank stuff out of here. It was like only four of us, including your brother. He did parts of it. I thank him. But this place was like ransacked. We had to knock out cubby holes, bank tellers and all that. So we're steady building. It's coming along, man. I pray every day while I'm in here, while I'm leaving and everything. So God has been good, man. And the vision, like you said, it's coming along. We still have a little bit more to do. This is our third month, I believe, in here. And as you see, when you walked in here, it's magnificent. And I thank God for it.
It is magnificent. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I know it's your establishment, so it's harder for you to talk about it because you don't want to be boastful. But mm-hmm. I know you're not that type of person. You're thankful to God. Mm-hmm. But here's some things that really caught my attention. And I want you to, you know, expound on this a little bit. The workout atmosphere that you created now, where you have the neon lights, you got flash screen TVs, you got hip hop music. I seen somebody on Facebook say, that's the only way I can work out with the type of atmosphere you have. Talk about that atmosphere you created.
Well, one thing I'm not ashamed to say that, first of all, that, you know, I was only expecting maybe even 25 today. I believe we had about like 9 in here. But I know, once again, I know God is going to make things happen. And like when I even started my gym for Jesus, it started out with like maybe 10. And next, you know, it ended up at 40 within the next 2 weeks. But that's the same thing that's happening here. The progress is real. I'm not worried about it. But this, yeah, that, you seeing these lights and everything, it's like a nightclub adventure. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, it's something that God gave me at 3 a.m. He always gave me creativity at 3 a.m. And so I said, let me come with a fitness nightclub to get everybody to dance, mingle, sweat, look sexy, and, you know, come fit at the same time.
I'm going to be honest with you. Mm-hmm. I've been all the way down to Miami, Florida, mm-hmm. shooting New York Fashion Week. I've never seen anything like this. Mm-hmm. It is amazing. Here in Youngstown, Ohio, are you kidding me? And, you know, tell people what they can expect. You know, you got the flat screen TVs in here. Mm-hmm. You got the facilities where you can box. You got the AstroTurf. Are you kidding me? Talk about the AstroTurf.
Well, you want to talk about the AstroTurf, man. I want to just hit you with this little scenario, this little story that happened. My mom, you know, she passed in 2009. And I've been dreaming about her lately. And it's like, I remember I had a dream two nights prior to what they gave me this, when they was telling me that I won. So I'm like, she called me poo-poo, that was my nickname. So she was rubbing my feet at the couch in the middle of the night, man. It seemed so real. She said, poo-poo, God is gonna, we gonna bring you a blessing. So the next couple nights, I come back here. That was supposed to be like $4,000. The guy said, "Are you sitting down?" I said, "Well, I'm sitting down." But the way he was talking, it seemed like it was gonna be a problem. So I was like, "I said, is everything all right?" He said, "Yeah, everything all right." He said, "Are you sitting down though?" I said, "Yeah, I'm sitting down." He said, "I just want to tell you something. All that work we did for you, that turf, that was $4,000." He said, "You ready for this?" I said, "I think I am." He said, "We did it for free." Wow. And he said, "Because we seen the passion in your eyes when you was up there." Once again, I was telling you the vision. They said, "We seen the tears in your eyes, the passion for these kids, what you trying to do." And we usually deal with like 200 companies, organizations. He said, "Everybody said we want to give it to you." And so I won it.
Absolutely phenomenal testimony.
Yeah.
Now, you talk about God a lot, and you incorporate that in your regimens and your workouts for your athletes. You know, Vincent Van Peel talked about power, you know, positive thinking, but you take it a more spiritual approach in terms of body, soul, and spirit. Tell us how that all aligns up.
Well, first of all my brothers, man, you know, we all played on a professional level or collegiate level. We come from a great stampede of athletes. The thing is, man, my father, who's a deacon, short by like 5'10", and everybody else come out like 6'4". My mother was 6'1". My father always made sure that we serve the Lord before we go out there, wherever we do. We went to church probably like 3 days a week. Like, you know, like the Mount Calvary's and stuff. We was going to a Baptist church. But he was a deacon. My mother was a gospel songwriter, pianist, and a lot of us were singers, you know. But y'all still be trying to sing to this day. But anyway, so yeah, you know, we come from my father. My father, like, he made sure that we serve God, man. And I'm glad he introduced all my siblings and myself to God, man, because that's what we need first. Even with the kids, I stress God, G-F-S-S, God, family, school, sports. You got to be a student athlete. You got to believe in God. Have God first. Respect your parents, family, and all that. Then you do those and stay humble and not being a bragger, you know. And you do those things, everything can fall in the right place.
Now, I was able to witness some young ladies that were in here and all types of shapes, you know. And the thing about it, I didn't see not one of them feel insecure. Like, how is it that you make everybody feel comfortable, whether they're in shape or out of shape?
Well, I push everybody to the limit. I mean, like, I help them. They act like they be scared at first. And it's not even the heavier ones. They be the ones that's, like, fatigued. And I just tell them, man, I groom myself into the workout. I say the first workout, okay, it probably hurts you a little bit. The second workout, you'd be like, oh, know what to expect the next day. The third workout, you'd be like, okay, I got this. The fourth workout, you'd be calling me like, Ray, where you at? We at 3:30 appointment, I'm getting there at 3:40. And they like waiting for me at 3:20. And I shouldn't say that, but anyway, yeah. So, I mean, they just got the knack for it now. They got the energetic, and I just push them.
Now, I'm gonna give you some inside information. One of my models, Brandy Day, I did a photo shoot with her.
My little cousin.
And she came to my studio in my house, and we shot. I was doing a calendar. And when she seen the pictures, she was like, "Oh no, you cannot." And when she seen herself, she's like, "You cannot post those pictures." The next thing I know, I seen her in here, got herself together. How'd you get her right so fast?
Well, you know, these girls want to be thick. I hate to say it, but they went and had the big butts and all that type of stuff. But first of all, I had to, like, of course, when you start working out, you're going to start losing weight. Because she only built me for like a good 10 workouts, and she came down. So I didn't know, if she would have told me that she would just lose her stomach and just be thicker, then I would have given her the routine now. Because I'm going through a person right now that, who was kind of like somewhat slim. She in the big butt, whatever you want, if I'm allowed to say that. She's in the big derriere. She's, her arms getting big, and she's doing a real good thing. I mean, like, she's happy the way she looked.
I mean, I'm gonna throw a little plug out here. Like, we living in the days of Nicki Minaj, Cardi B, and Megan Thee Stallion. So it is popular for girls to have the little waist and the big derriere.
Right.
What can you do for them to get them looking like that now?
The type of squats. I mean, once again, man, I come in even with guys, like exercises. I got different type of exercises, man, that, once again, God gave me. Like, I've created a thing called bicycle bench, and I don't know if I showed these guys yet. Once we do that fitness nightclub, I'll get on the bench and start dancing on the bench, doing the benching. But I just have a lot of, you know, I study a lot, study my body a lot when I'm at home by myself or whether I'm in here. And so I work on the muscles and stuff, and I also read the books.
Now, talk about your VIP area. I was really impressed with that. The glass area. Like, when you come in here, the infrastructure is so nice. But I like the VIP area. I like the area towards the front where, you know, people, when they come in, if you have an event where they pay, they got people at the booth right there. And then, you know, you got beverages and stuff that you sell. Mm-hmm. Like, you just making it so friendly, home-friendly environment where you don't have to go outside and exercise. And when you come in here, like, if you want to take a break, you know, you could go take a break. Mm-hmm. I see you got a little game over here you could play. You know,
oh, yeah.
What was your vision for that, to just make it so, you know, friendly, home-friendly?
Well, going to the VIP, that first, that's basically like a lounge. Once they work out, they can go chill in there and mingle and talk and all that type stuff. No drugs. We don't do no drugs up in here. But they will, like I said, sit back and chill, you know, relax, you know, on the nice sofa and everything. And actually, that VIP room right there is about to be a music studio. So, yeah, it's about to be a music studio. So, with the game room, this is like a YMCA/Planet Fitness. / Boys and Girls Club. That's basically what it all. I just don't have no swimming pool. But somebody made a joke, said, man, you the Planet Fitness of the hood. I'm like, okay, if you want to call it that. But anyway, that's why I'm trying to get more games in here for the kids, because I deal with a lot of the kids. And we also, we got a kitchen in the back where we'll be serving kids food, like, you know, different things of that nature.
Now tell everyone how they can find you on social media.
You can find me on social media. I got two accounts. So the one is with my banner. I believe it's this banner right here. It's Raymond, R-A-Y-M-O-N-D, Merrow, M-A-R-R-O-W. And also, you can email me at all lowercase, Ray, R-A-Y, Mar, M-A-R-M-I-P, stand for Men in Progress, 15@yahoo.com. You can call me on my cell at 330-707-6177.
Now, do you plan on getting some shirts for people? What do you plan on doing with that?
Actually, I have some shirts already up there at Warmby's that I had got like 2 years. I mean, they've been sitting there for about a year. And now, since I put on Facebook, I'll say I'm looking for t-shirt makers. I get over 1,000, and I wouldn't support my black-owned businesses. I have a lot in my inbox on my wall, over, probably like 60 comments of 60 different organizations. I was surprised, but I'm like, that's good. So I'm going to see, you know, I'm going to put it out there, my emblem out there, and see who can do it the best. But I have like a little contest type thing, and that's when I go from there.
And going into 2021, what is the goals that you have set?
Well, I could talk about a couple, a couple programs I have coming. Of course, my organization, Men in Progress, keeping young men off the streets. You know, and also, what's the other thing we have? We're going to have like some things with the Valentine. I'm bringing Jam for Jesus back, which is a gospel fitness program where I had like over 35 women, all ages from like 70 on down, and we jammed the gospel music, gospel aerobics, doing different things of that. And then, as you see the arena out there, I'm trying to have like a 3 and 4 to 5 year old soccer league where I'm gonna get remember I told you about that, trying to build a thing, and I just saw a construction guy. He said he's gonna come in looking at it tomorrow, see what they can do. So we'll do something like that, because 3 and 4 year olds, I really want to do something with them.
Well, thank you for your time. Mm-hmm. I think the facilities are excellent. We're going to go out here and we're going to do some footage with the lights off and some footage with the lights on so they can see how amazing and how magnificent the facilities are.
Right. Thank you.
Desdemon Lake.
And tell us where they can find you on social media.
My Instagram is deslake_. So DESLAKE_. My Twitter It's Dez Lake 21. That's really it for real.
And tell us what you felt about the experience being here at Ray Merle's Fitness Center today.
Well, when I first came in, I was really going to Family Dollars, which is right next door for real. I feel like it was a good atmosphere. I see how big he was. I know he'll be able to help me improve my body, you know what I mean, for the season. And also, he wants you to do better, so he wants to see you do great for real. Definitely a great atmosphere and great environment.
Now, just my first time seeing you, but when I came in, you was catching balls like Randy Moss. So tell us a little bit about your history, even as far back as Pop Warner, if you played Pop Warner. Tell us a little bit about your history of sports.
I did play Little League. I played Little League up until I was like 13. I never played middle school. I played in high school. I played my freshman year. Never finished my 4 year in high school. I played my senior year. Didn't finish the 4 year. I went to two JUCOs, two community colleges. I went to a school in California. And I went to a school in Nelsonville, Ohio. I went to a Division II school at Urbana. We had got shut down. So now, right now, I'm at Ohio Dominican. I play free safety. I'm 6'3", 190. Yeah, I've been playing my whole life for real. You know, football changed my life for real.
Now let me ask you something. Can you dunk?
Yes.
Now that's going to you a beast on the field. If you could dunk the ball and you that tall, 6'3", playing safety with speed, it ain't really too much going over
right.
Your head.
Right. They hardly throw my way for real.
Yeah, so you got that closing speed.
Yes.
Okay, let me ask you your all-time top two DBs, safeties or corners, it don't matter.
DBs of all time, it would be my favorite safety is Troy Polamalu, then Ed Reed. So they're my two favorite.
Okay, now I met Ed Reed. I shoot for the Pro Football Hall of Fame, so I got a lot of pictures on my social media of him. But yeah, real good dude. And then my daughter got a chance to interview Ray Lewis, and that's her favorite player and her favorite team. Her name's India Ray. So okay. The atmosphere tonight was a whole lot different. You know, they had the strobe lights, the night lights. You know, it looked really nice because for tonight, they set the atmosphere up now where people can listen to hip-hop music and get their workout while they have, you know, almost like a club atmosphere. What'd you think about that?
Well, I actually like what he's doing with the nightlife. It definitely bring more better feeling to it, more positive feel to it. Definitely gonna bring more people in once they be able to see what it actually looked like in the inside, and once what it started with, or how it started before, because at first it was a bank. He definitely did a great job in here. I like what he's doing with it, bringing in a nightclub. He also wanna bring in some more stuff he can do every Friday. So definitely a positive spot. You guys wanna come check it out, get a workout in, meet new people, and just grow, you know what I mean? Meet new people, like I said, and, you know what I mean?
Now, was you impressed with the equipment, the ellipticals, the free weights? Tell us a little bit about that, you know, how you can work out your whole body 360.
Well, you can work out your whole body here. You can squat, you can bench, you can get on the treadmill, you got balance, you can do everything. Everything you can do at a normal facility, you can do in here. You can get stronger, use machines for strength. You got core machines, you got machines for your calves, calf raise. You got balls in here where you can throw the balls and get your hands together. You got medicine balls where you can work on different stuff. So you got all the equipment you need in here. If you want to get better, want to get in better shape and fit, this is definitely the spot to be for sure.
Well, I'll say this, after your sports career is over with, you definitely have a career in sportscaster.
So oh yeah, for sure.
Great job with the interview.
I appreciate you.
For your time.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay, we have our second interviewee. Tell us your name.
My name is Brian Douglas.
And Mr. Lewis, you look like you could box. I was out there checking out the facilities for Ray Merle's Fitness Center, and I seen the little punching bag thing.
Yeah.
You ever hit that before?
I mean, I have touched it a couple times. I ain't really get active with it, but
So yeah.
All right, you look like you got some quick hands.
Yeah.
In terms of basketball.
Yeah, I play basketball.
AI
basketball.
Skills, you know what I'm saying? Cross somebody over.
Yeah, I play a little bit of basketball.
So next time you come out, I want to see what you can do with that punching. Where's a punching bag, right?
Yes.
And I want to see what you can do with that punching bag with your hands, you know. So it's just amazing out there. You know one thing I like? I like the TV, the flat screen TV up there.
Yes, yes, yes.
I think that vibe is really
that's
nice.
That's great for the atmosphere we in.
Yeah.
It's like,
you know,
sports
so,
atmosphere.
And
that's all that's on.
Exactly. You know, football's back. So, you know, even if you come in here on a Saturday, they got, you know, sports for Saturday, football games.
Yeah.
The music is great. Tell us a little bit about the music.
I mean, he allows you to play pretty much whatever you want. He's kid-friendly when the kids are in. But then when the adults are in, he could really play hip-hop, R&B, whatever you like.
Now, I'm glad that you mentioned that. It's a great point. This is like the one-stop shop for your entire family.
Yes.
I know I picked up a lot of weight from, you know, the pandemic, and I know a lot of people been in the house, Thanksgiving, now we're heading into Christmas season, just eating and packing on the weights. So, would you recommend this place for, like, a whole entire family?
Yes.
Husband, wife, you know, brother, sister.
Yes, this is very family friendly. It's like, I could bring my little brother in if I need to. He can come get some work in with the little kids. Or my mom could come in and run, jog on the treadmill if she needs some work.
Now, I've seen you catching some balls today, some footballs, and, you know, you were sitting on the ground, but it looked like you wasn't hurt. It got something to do with that AstroTurf that's out there.
Oh, yeah.
Talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, he got turf. We got, like, 20-yard turf where you could just do anything, get your footwork right, balance, catch a couple footballs. Whatever you need, really.
Now, I was going to say that. You on the other side of the camera now because you're getting ahead of me. But I was thinking about the footwork, and when I seen you, I was like, man, y'all looking like y'all out here working in the Calabans.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But you can actually do that. You can get the cones. I know they sell the cones at Walmart's.
Yes.
You could pick the cones up and work on your footwork speed and stuff like that.
Yes.
Very athletic person yourself. Tell us a little bit about your history for athletics.
Yes, I grew up playing Little League for the Westside Patriots. Receiver, DB all my life. I went up to middle school at Austintown Middle School. Played a little bit there. Went into their freshman year. Played football, played DB at Fitch. But then transferred over to Cheney. And, I'm a receiver now. I didn't play took my sophomore year off. End up playing my junior year and my senior this year. And I averaged about 23.5 yards every time I got the ball, so that's pretty good this year. So, yeah.
What number were you?
I had number 6.
Okay. Doc Jett on the football field.
Yeah.
All right, now, I used to play for the Westside Patriots. When I played, we had the Denver Broncos looking colors.
Yeah, I do remember that.
Yeah, we had the blue pants,
a couple
blue and orange jerseys.
Yeah.
You know, so it's crazy because I was like on the line playing guard. But I'm gonna tell you right now, my coach was a beast. Like the guard, you got the pull, so you get the pull and knock people out.
Yeah.
You know, and sweeps and stuff like that.
Yes,
38
yes,
sweep, guard pull, knocking people out. That's when I became really physical playing on the line.
Yeah.
And then that was you know, Little League, my junior high school. I went to Hayes High School. They didn't have a football team, so I missed 2 years. My best prime years, like all he misses prime years, have to go to jail.
Yeah.
And then basically, when I went to the Rand High School, I was playing football all the time, just for the love of it, just playing backyard football, tag, rough and tumble. And I lost all that weight. So then when I went to play football for the Rand High School as a freshman, I was a skinny dude and I was knocking cats out because I was already
had
big
that mentality
and on the line, but just for playing basketball and, you know, like your friend, I learned how to dunk and all that stuff. And
yes. People
didn't even know I could dunk. You know what I'm saying? And a baseball cat taught me. He was like, man, dunk. And I was like, I can't. So he gave me a baseball. He's a test to run for us, a test to run. Then he gave me a baseball, said dunk that, I dunked that. Then he gave me a little kid's ball that I could palm that. And then he said, now if you could do all that, you could dunk. And he kept screaming at me like, jump, jump. And I was getting mad at him screaming at me. And then I just went up, boom. And then punched it was easy. And then I said, there ain't nobody know I could dunk like Spud Webb. Ain't nobody know I could dunk. So we had a big game going on, and the Project Bully of Westlake was there playing. And everybody's afraid of him. And I said, if I get two steps on him, I'm banging on him. And then the middle opened up, I got the two steps, he was under the rim, and I fleshed on him. And everybody just went crazy because they didn't know I could dunk.
Yeah,
you know? So tell us one of your stories, you know, when something happened and you were element of surprise.
It probably gotta be my junior year playing football. At Cheney, it was like, at first, at the beginning of the season, I really didn't get to start. It was my first year back playing football, so they didn't know what I could really do, my capability was. So then I think we were going into the fifth week, I want to say, we played Ursuline. So then I finally got my chance to start, and then I think late in the first, my quarterback decides to throw it up. He's on the run getting chased, so he throws it up. 1-on-1 with a corner, I go up, moss him. So then that's when everybody was like, oh, yeah. He raw.
I know the Chili's was going crazy.
Fans, everybody was going wild. My
the
mom.
The next day, you went to school the next day.
Proud.
You weren't talking about sitting that day, right?
Nah.
You had to go to school. And, you know, even if you wasn't on the lunch thing, you going to lunch that
year.
Because everybody coming over to you, talking about, you know.
Yeah,
so,
yes.
Let me ask you something. What has the internet done for you during the pandemic? Just being in the house and stuff. Have you become more computer savvy?
I would say a little bit. I check Instagram more than I like. I shouldn't. I don't like that, but yeah.
Okay, tell everybody real slowly what your Instagram is.
My Instagram is red with 2 D's, REDD _6.
Okay, so y'all know where to find him at. Now, we're going to end up, since you did such a great job, we're going to end up asking you, what do you think about Ray Merle's Fitness Center?
Oh, it's amazing. It was like, the way I found it was pretty similar to Dez. I was going to Dollar General with my mom. We left. And then I just so happened to look up and like, well, you know that place. And then she saw the name, so she was familiar with it. We came in, and I saw the Ray. He was toned, very toned, huge. So I'm like, oh yeah. I told my mom, we got back in the car, I'm like, we got to get in there somehow and make it happen, please. So then she made it happen. Yeah,
now I'm going to say something about his family, his entire family, all known for playing football, Little League, high school, even the pros. And Ray, they call him the Rifleman. You know, so I was talking to him today, yeah. Saying, when he played semi-pro, I believe it was the Steelers, Youngstown Steelers, but I literally just seen him just throwing like 80-yard passes, you know, without even twisting his body into it, like crazy passes. Like you thinking that somebody punting the ball, like Ray Guy, who's a Pro Football Hall of Famer, punting the ball, like he was throwing that far. And I told him, I said, man, Cass was just dropping they was dimes though, but Cass was dropping TDs left and right because, and I called one of the receivers over to him, I was like, dude, you gotta keep running.
Yeah.
He's going to overthrow you. I don't care how far you go. Like, you don't think he going to throw it short. You got to keep running.
All right.
And so they kept running, and then they was able
finally
to
connect.
You know, yeah. So tell us in terms of, I mean, you look like you ran track before. You ever
Yep. Oh, yeah.
Tell me a little bit about track and getting your speed up and your footwork. How do you get your speed up in here?
Yeah. So by doing really explosive drills, like squatting, it really helps a lot with your thighs, balance, that can help you getting off the blocks more explosive. And then like really you can work on your stride on the turf, so that helps a lot with track. Your stride is very important in track. I know that. That's all I had, for real. I wasn't the quickest person, but my stride was amazing, so that's really got me far.
All right, now your friend, he did an awesome job, so I'm gonna ask him to go interview you real quick, because I told him after his career is over, He got a job as sportscaster. So take the mic and however you want to interview your friend over here. We're going to end up like that. That's going to be pretty dope.
That little man, pigeon.
You got it, well.
Come in frame a little bit. Come over a little bit more. All right. Okay. So now, this is your show, and you can ask him whatever you want, and we're just going to keep it PG, but just have fun with it.
Oh, yeah, most definitely, man. Well, yeah, I'm sitting here with my dog, Red, man. I mean, he was actually training with me before Club 7, you know what I mean? So, y'all know about Club 7, man, you know. Definitely go check them guys out for sure, man, Youngstown. But no, man, what's your plans, you know, after high school? What you want to do?
I'm undecided, so, like, what college I want to go to right now, but pretty sure I'm definitely going to college for sure, guaranteed, but undecided right now. But I definitely, after that, to the league, that's number one goal.
That's cool. Sometimes it's good to take time off. I had to take time off too. So, you know, you played at, how many different high schools did you play at?
Two.
You played at two different high schools. How long was you at Cheney?
I was at Cheney for three years actually, but I didn't play my sophomore year. All
right. So, what school did you say you did the best at?
Definitely did at Cheney Cowboy.
Cheney. Do you feel like Cheney solidified your spot for you being one of the top prospects in the Youngstown area?
Yes, for sure. The coaches really bought into me and what I had going on. I trained a lot over the summer, and that really was what got me there with Club 7.
Oh, man, that's what's up, man. So I want to ask, man, I'm going to say your biggest weakness that you wanted to work on coming to Ray Morales. Like, what you wanted to work on the most to improve your game and go to the next level?
Physically, everything. You could say I ain't the biggest person, but physically, everything. Bigger legs. I want to just tone up.
Well, that's good, man, because I want to do the same exact thing, you know what I mean? So I just want to tell you, man, you got it, man. Keep pushing for where you going, you know what I mean? And we going to the next level for sure, man. I ain't got no more questions, man, so I'm going to sit here, you know what I mean, lay the camera.
Get out of here, man.
You know what I mean?
A for A.
Hey, but nah, man, but most definitely, though, come to Ray Morales, man. You want to get better, you know what I mean? If you're the type of person where you like working out by yourself, this is a good spot to go. You can have your headphones in, you know what I mean? You can put your phone on speaker if you want it, you know what I mean? This is definitely a great spot, you know what I mean? You got turf in here. You can work on a lot of speed, a lot of explosive drills, do a lot of lunging, step-ups, really whatever. For I learned a lot of explosive drills. You could do some balance, stuff like that for real. But yeah, Ray Morales spot right here on the west side off of Mahoney in this plaza where the Family Dollar is located at. You guys definitely should come check it out. It's not too far. It's not in a bad spot where costs be. It's definitely in a good area. You know what I mean? Bring your kids. Bring your moms. Yeah. Everybody who want to come and get in shape definitely should come. It's definitely a spot, though, man. But yeah. Let's get it, man. 330, man. Youngstown, Ohio, in the building, you know what I mean? Put us on the map, man. You know what I mean? This is just a start. That's why we here. We trying to get better. We trying to be the best we could be. You know what I mean? We ain't worried about no competition. We just out here winning. You know what I mean?
For sure.
Yes, sir.